That's a good intro. That's the kind of music that just makes you want to move. Hey, everybody. Welcome to another episode of SoTellus Time, where we talk about everything that's important. We talk about only important things, right?
Absolutely.
Only important things. The only important things in your life we talk about every single day. Today, we're going to be talking about cut it loose. You gotta cut it loose, Troy. Does that mean like footloose? Like,
yes. We're gonna talk about dancing today.
I almost started to like just sing the Batman, the old Batman.
Like, that's not the cut loose song.
Well, that's true. He was the first one to cut it loose, looking good in those spandex.
There you
right?
go.
All right. So, what in your life, personally and professionally, do you need to cut loose that is wasting time, wasting energy, money, and most importantly, your happiness? And we've got some pretty good examples Troy came up with here of people who cut things out so it stopped wasting time in their life, and they're people that we want to pay attention to. So Troy, let's jump right in.
Yeah, so the other day I was watching Shark Tank, and Mark Cuban's on there, and he's the billionaire on Shark Tank. And it was really funny because he made a comment that someone brought in a product that was supposed to help you make your bed faster. And he said, well, he goes, I'm not going to invest in this because, you know, it's just not my thing. And they're like, oh, really? And he's like, oh, yeah. He goes, I haven't made my bed in like 20 years.
I haven't bed my maid?
Yeah.
I hope he hasn't bed his maid.
He hasn't done that either. So he says, I haven't made my bed. And he literally said, he goes, I figured it out how much time it took me every single day to make my bed. Yeah. And then I calculated that out over my lifetime, and I realized that was a ton of wasted time that I could, you know, could spend doing more important things in my life. So he doesn't make his bed. Totally weird. I would assume, as a billionaire, that somebody else makes his bed.
Listen, somebody's is making his bed. That's for sure.
Right?
I don't make my bed either. I think it's a waste of time. My wife does. Oh, she's going to kill me for that one. I'm just kidding, honey. I'm just kidding.
All right. The other one is, and most people probably know this, but like Steve Jobs from Apple. He had like tons of these black turtlenecks.
Yeah.
And he wore the same turtleneck and jeans pretty much every single day. And the reason why is because he did not want to waste time deciding what to wear.
Yeah.
Every time when he got up in the morning.
Smart.
Yeah, another one is Mark Zuckerberg. I saw a quote from him where he said that, same thing, he learned that Steve Jobs did this, so he adopted the same thing. And what he said was, he says, I have so many important decisions that I have to make on a daily basis running a multi-billion dollar business that I don't need to waste any time figuring out what I'm going to wear that day.
Totally.
So cut it out. They cut those decisions out of their lives and then figured out how to use that time more effectively.
Most people get dressed in the morning to impress other people, right? Well, Mark Zuckerberg, Mark Cuban, Steve Jobs, guess what? They impress people with their money.
Yeah, because Mark Zuckerberg is always wearing like sandals, shorts, and a hoodie.
He looks like a hobo, but dude, he can pull the hottest. Right? Any one of them can. Mark Cuban, now he's always on point.
Yes,
he's always looking good. He's looking fly.
All right, so let's talk about some things. Here's some ideas of what you might be able to cut loose in your life.
Yeah.
Right? Some are going to be work, some are going to be personal. But the point is, things that are taking up your time, like Trevor said, wasting time, energy, money, or happiness. So one of the first ones was employees.
Oh, yeah.
And we've done a podcast on this before.
Yeah.
Where we've talked about, you know, bad employees and, you know, and how detrimental they can be to your business.
Yeah. Or even just not even bad employees, but maybe not productive ones either.
Yeah.
Ones that are just kind of there and they're, it's amazing how companies hold on to people for a really long time because they just have a hard time letting them go.
Yeah.
Or maybe you're big enough that you have so many employees. I mean, Troy, when you guys had 150 employees, how many of them probably just skirted through? I mean, you knew you would walk into offices they'd be playing video games.
Yeah, absolutely. Right. But right? We were so big. Actually, I think at our peak, we were like almost 800 to 1,000 employees.
Oh my
and
gosh.
It's like, yeah, you could just like squeak by and most people wouldn't have a clue that you weren't doing anything.
Yeah. I remember you guys had one employee there that you guys didn't really know what she did. Well, I mean, you knew, but she wasn't under you and they actually created work for her so that she could keep her job because, you know, the person above her was her friend. And so they created. She wasn't even qualified for it, but they figured out how, and actually we did some training and helped her out, and she, you know, got to work a few more years doing that. I mean, it's amazing to me.
Exactly. So employees, and it could be a lot of times, what's funny too, is because a lot of times it's like, oh man, I got this employee, he's not very good. And, you know, he wastes time and he wastes my time, but I don't have time to go get a new employee.
Yeah.
Right. But you don't think about how much time is being wasted dealing with the bad employee. Mm-hmm. Right. So you cut them out and you get a new employee, and you put that effort in and you have somebody who's good.
Right.
So another one is programs, you know, so those programs could be software in your company, or it could be, you know, just internal programs that you utilize. Mm-hmm. Are there programs out there that, you know, are a waste of your time? They're not productive. They're not really producing or are worth the amount of time spent in them.
Yeah, like it's funny because you probably have programs that you haven't even opened or used in a long time. I just got a notification from Google today telling me to change 4 passwords on 4 different programs. And as I'm listing them off, Troy's like, we haven't used that in like 5 years. And I'm like, oh, well, there you go. Let's just delete it.
Exactly. Another one is products. You know, do you have products or services in your business that really aren't worth it or they're not profitable, but you just keep offering those services or products because they're there?
Well, yeah. And we had a carpet cleaner that he had bought a bunch of like stain remover, and for some reason he thought he was going to sell it at first, and it didn't go the way he wanted with selling it and everything. And so it's just been sitting on his shelves. It was sitting on his shelves forever. And I thought, why don't you start something where you give it away, right? Yeah. Include it in one of your packages, or when they do this, they get this. Having it just sit on your shelf is doing you no good, and it's doing nobody else any good, right?
Right.
But it could be.
Yeah, but giving it to your client, they're like, oh, wow, you're the first carpet cleaner that's ever left me something to clean, you know, my carpets after the fact. So yeah, absolutely. Marketing. Mm. Do you have any marketing strategies or marketing you're paying for that just doesn't work anymore?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's a big one. Partnerships.
Well, with marketing, really quick too, I want to point out on that is, with marketing, and you need to know, and this is why we always talk about it, know your numbers.
Yep.
Because when is the right time to cut it out? You know, if it's not profitable, that's the right time to cut it out. Troy and I, we've been talking about this too with some of our marketing strategies, and some things have shifted and changed, and the cost per acquisition has gone up. And so we're debating, is it worth it? Are we still going to keep doing this? And at the end of the day, it is still profitable. So as long as it's profitable, we're like, well, let's keep doing it, right? Because it's still revenue coming in. It's not as profitable as it used to be. But does that mean that we just go cut it out? And we get that all the time. People will be like, oh, well, the SEO is really working now. Should I cut off the PPC? And you've heard me say it before. Is the PPC working? Does it bring you business? And they're like, well, yeah, then why would you cut it out? Don't cut it out. So don't cut it out if it's profitable. Yes. I think that's a good thing, because a lot of people in business, I think they cut things out too quickly.
Yep.
But if it's not profitable, get rid of it right away.
Exactly. So the next one is partnerships.
Oh my gosh.
You know, and
most important decision you'll ever make.
Exactly. So are you in a partnership that doesn't work? And this could be a partner as in like a partner in your business where you're co-owners or something like that. Or it could just be partnerships that you have with other businesses that just aren't profitable anymore or are not worth your time. You know, we've had that happen in the last 20 years several times, where it's like we put all this energy effort into a partnership and there's all these promises of what's going to happen and it doesn't happen, and then we're like, why are we wasting our time?
Well, last week we met with like 7 new potential customers that were wanting to come on, and I think 5 of the 7 had all experienced horrible partnerships.
Yes.
Where they either lost the original business, or the partner sucked all the money out of the bank account, or they, you know, totally screwed them over. You know, all sorts of things. I heard where one partner started sleeping with the other partner's wife. I mean, it was just, be careful who you're bringing into your business and your life, right?
Exactly. Another one is vendors. You know, what vendors do you have? Are they still good relationships? Are they still worth it? Are you making money off of the relationship, or are you putting too much time, energy, and effort into it?
Are they still promoting you?
Exactly. And now we're going to get into some of the more personal ones, but these are really important too, because you only have so many hours in a day.
Yeah.
So
and you got to make all those important decisions, like what shirt you're going to wear and how you make your bed.
Exactly. So you might have to cut out some of these other things in your personal life to make room for that.
That's right.
So one of them is friends and associates.
Friends.
And this one is...
Who has friends?
Right? This one is kind of a hard one. You know, take a look at your friends. Take a look at the people you hang out with. Are they bringing you up? Are they making you a better person? Or do they bring you down?
Mm-hmm.
Do they waste your time?
Mm-hmm.
Right? Are those relationships getting in the way of more important relationships?
That's right. Well, I tell my kids all the time, and it's still true for adults, show me your friends and I'll show you your future, right?
Yes.
It seriously is such a true statement. And maybe your parents said the same thing to you, but think about it. Who are the people that are surrounding you right now? And if they're not successful people, and I don't mean like go hang out with a bunch of arrogant suckers that think, you know, they're the bomb, but if they're not motivated, positive, successful people, cut them out of your life. And I and when I say successful, that I mean in life. Right. I don't just mean financially. If you're judging everybody by how much they make, then you are surrounded by the wrong type of people. That is for sure. So if they're not successful in life, cut them out.
Yep, exactly. All right, another one is, and this one takes a lot of people's time, hobbies.
Mm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Are there any hobbies, anything that you do that, you know, and we're not saying that hobbies are bad.
No.
But is there anything that takes up a ton of your time that could be spent better somewhere else?
Well, and I've met a lot of people who have hobbies that it doesn't actually, and it sounds stupid, right? And so you wouldn't even call it a hobby, but they do, that doesn't bring them that satisfaction or gratification or release or, you know, that relaxation in their life. They look at it as like, like one guy, he said his hobby was flipping houses, but it was so stressful. It wasn't his day job. It was his hobby, but it was so stressful for him. Another guy was remodeling RVs and he loved it. And yet everything I ever heard about was complaining of this problem and this problem. Oh, and there was water damage and we broke into the walls. And then, man, we ended up having to take the whole wall down and, you know, all this stuff. So are you viewing the things that you call a hobby as, are they actually something that, you know, gives you that satisfaction, that like, I'm relaxed, I'm happy. It was something great that I did over the weekend.
It brings you happiness.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, as my son would say, you know, it's not a good hobby. And actually, if you're an NBA fan, the New York Knicks have a habit of being a losing team for a very, very long time. And, you know, if you're a Knicks fan, if that's your hobby and all it does is aggravate you and make you super upset because they always lose, why is that your hobby? Right?
All the Knicks fans on our show are like, I hate you.
But the Knicks are doing really good this year. So I can say that because they're turning it around this year. And now would be the time to have that as your hobby.
Yeah.
Right? Because it can make you happy. But if it's not making you happy, then maybe
like
not
the
worth
past
it.
Past years were like, it sucks to be a Knicks fan.
Right? Okay. Another one is social media. And we've talked about this before.
Time sucker.
Yes. Big time sucker in lots of people's lives. So is what you're doing on social media worth it, or is it literally just wasting your time?
Totally. That's personally and professionally. I call it fluff marketing.
Yep.
It's so hard to track. And it's when I talk to people about social media marketing and everything like that, we call it fluff marketing, not direct marketing. You've heard us talk about it before, but you sit down to even do work on social media and then you end up getting sucked in for hours into all the crap.
Yes. Exactly. Another one is habits. Do you have any habits in your life that are sucking your time?
Yeah. Like, do you turn the light switch on and off 50 times before you walk out the door?
Yeah, that's a bad habit.
Might be a tick.
That's a waste of your time.
Might be a little OCD. Might need some medication.
That. Exactly. Seek help for that one. But are there any other habits in your life that, you know, that take a lot of your time? And this one rolls kind of into the next one, which is addictions.
Mm.
Are there any addictions in your life that are just sucking, you know, the happiness out of your life or the money out of your life? Or I actually saw a post the other day and it talked about, you know, that the average smoker smokes 2 packs a day.
Wow.
And if you take that and you times that out over the lifetime and you invest that in, you know, just a mutual fund, it was like over $1 million retirement.
No way.
Yeah, just from 2 packs a day, right? So it's a habit, but it's an addiction that has a very negative effect, not only on your health,
yeah,
but financially, versus the positive effect of what if you took that and took that money and invested
it. Oh my gosh, every smoker, I should start smoking. I got to take up that habit just so I can quit that habit and start putting that money into a mutual fund, right? Like every smoker that's listening right now, yeah, you got that cigarette in your mouth right now. Literally get that thing, put it out and take that money and start putting into a mutual fund. That's that's incredible.
And again, you'll live long enough to get the mutual fund.
Yes.
That's the other thing too. We want you to live a long time.
Yes, you want to be happy and you want to be healthy and you want to enjoy it. Trust me.
Yeah, so if there's any addictions out there, cut them loose.
Get rid of it, because an addiction is never going to make you happy.
All right, so what is the homework, Trevor?
Homework for today, for this week. Come up with 10 things that you can cut loose in your life. 10 things. So think about it. This is something like, oh, you know, I don't want you to just be like, oh yeah, I could cut this out, or oh, maybe I'll get rid of that one employee, or maybe whatever. I'm not going to make my bed anymore. You know, like, no, 10 things. Come up with 10 things this week that you can cut loose in your business and your personal life. So if you're, you know, really motivated, 10 things personally and 10 things professionally, you will be so much happier. It was like the other day, my wife was like, I need you to go through your closet and get rid of all your shirts. Get rid of like all these shirts and everything. I said, no, I love my shirts. What are you talking about? She goes, I swear you wear like the same 5 to 10 shirts and you have like 10,000 in here. And so I did. I started pulling the shirts down and I started thinking, when I was thinking about it, when I actually stopped to think about it and look at them and pull those shirts down, I thought, oh yeah, I don't wear this one. Oh yeah, I don't wear this one. Oh yeah, I don't wear this one anymore. And then I had this huge pile of shirts that I was able to go and donate. It was awesome. And guess what else that meant? I got to go shopping for more shirts.
That might be an addiction.
Nah, it's definitely an addiction. Not a lot of people, not a lot of guys like to say they like to shop, but let me tell you, I think it's fun. I love shopping. So, and my wife loves the fact that I love shopping.
There you go.
That's right.
Yeah, so one of the ones I cut out was social media. I looked the other day,
wow,
and we just did that great trip, and I didn't post anything on social media. So I thought, man, I should have posted something from our trip. Maybe I'll go back and do that. And I went back and looked, and I have not posted anything on social media since November of last year.
So you're so lucky.
And then I looked at it, and I thought about how much time that had saved me since November. And I was like, oh, man.
Yeah.
And I didn't post anything. I didn't post anything. Right.
No, I'll tell you what. The thing is, something I started doing this year was when I get home from work, I go into my bedroom, I throw my phone on the bed, and I walk out the door. I walk out, I go into the living room, and I hang out with my kids and my wife, and we go and do fun things.
Yep.
So that's one thing that I am not going to be letting suck up my time is my phone anymore. And you know what? There's a lot of people that go, oh, I can never do that. I can never do that because, you know, too many important calls, too many important text messages. I'll miss everything. Well, guess what? It's still important the next day. So it's funny. A lot of times I'll walk in there and yeah, sure. There's 5 or 6 missed text messages and some phone calls and everything like that. And the next morning when I wake up, I give people a call and I text them back.
Yep.
And I take care of whatever it was at that time. And it usually wasn't anything that was life altering. So, all right, guys. Well, this was really fun. Happy Tuesday. Hope you guys have a phenomenal week. And we will catch you on the next episode of SoTellus Time.